Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Our2Cents. And as Sharon and I have constantly told you guys, we want to make this channel as wholesome as possible.
Exactly. And you guys know, health is wealth. But at the same time, there's a lot about this topic that is yet to be explored and understood. And that is why we partner up with the Nairobi Hospital so that they bring in their experts. Yes. And they can share with us their wealth of knowledge. And we can go back into our lives and lifestyles the wiser. Okay.
Wiser and living a better and longer, more productive life.
Amen, Susan.
You're welcome.
So today we've got Dr. Strukina with us, and she has over 20 years of experience, and she's currently a resident consultant at the Nairobi Hospital.
And you can find her at the non-surgery and bariatric surgery clinic.
Right. Yes. Which already I want to understand what that means and what it does. Are you ready to tell us?
Yeah.
Okay, so what is that? What do you do to the layman watching this who may not understand? What is it that you do and why is it important?
Yeah, we started the bariatric surgery clinic, weight loss clinic at Nairobi Hospital just recently. And practically what we do treatment of obesity.
Mm. Okay.
So that is the main purpose of this clinic. Doctors became now very interested in this topic as obesity is leading to many different diseases. Mm. Obesity is the main cause of type 2 diabetes.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Obesity is leading to high blood pressure. Obesity is associated with many, very many different diseases.
Mm.
So doctors came to the conclusion that without addressing obesity, without treating obesity, chances for the patient to recover from diabetes, high blood pressure, high cholesterol, other diseases which are caused by obesity will be minimum. So this initiative of Nairobi Hospital, it's really very good initiative, which now we started bariatric surgery clinic at the base of Nairobi Hospital for the reason of helping people to recover from all those diseases and to do prophylaxis also for all those diseases. Because if person is remaining obese, he will be in a great risk of developing of all those complications of obesity.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And sorry, I just wanted to rewind a bit. For those of us who want to understand what obesity is, what constitutes being obese?
Patient is considered to be obese if his body mass index more than 30.
More than 30.
More than 30. Body mass index, it is your weight divided by your height in meters square. Maybe you know it.
Mm.
But just to know that we are assessing patients' body mass index in order to know what type of treatment to advise to the patient.
Okay.
A very important also way of assessment of patient's weight is checking patient's waist circumference. We put tape measure around the waist, and we see what's the waist circumference. For the lady, waist circumference not supposed to be more than 80 centimeters.
80 centimeters.
Ladies. No more than 80. Okay, and the men? I saw you checking out our waist. Okay, good. And the men?
For the men, it's supposed to be less than 94.
94 centimeters. Ooh.
So if your waist circumference more than 80, it means that you started developing central obesity or abdominal obesity, which is showing presence of visceral obesity.
Which is fat around the organs?
Yes, exactly.
But so what is the difference between fat under the skin and fat around the organs? Is there one that is worse than the other?
Mm. Very important to know that there are two types of fat in our body. We have subcutaneous fat which you are saying, fat under the skin.
Mm-hmm.
This is so-called in medical world like white fat. And also we have fat which is accumulating in internal organs.
Mm.
Fat which is accumulated in liver, mm-hmm. in vessels, okay. in omentum, mm-hmm. fat which is accumulating around your heart, mm-hmm. pancreas, and all other vital organs. Mm-hmm. So those two types of fat, they are differently influencing metabolic reactions in our body.
Okay.
Visceral fat has very significant effect on metabolic reactions in our body. If we are talking about, if you will take one visceral fat which is inside mm-hmm. the organs, visceral fat is producing bioactive substances like hormones, mm-hmm. Hormones which are called like angiotensinogen, mm-hmm. resistin, leptin, interleukin. Those hormones are leading to different changes in our body. Those hormones are leading to high blood pressure. If we are talking about angiotensinogen, mm-hmm. this is the direction to high blood pressure.
Okay.
So that is where we have obesity, high blood pressure.
Right.
Those visceral fat cells are producing free fatty acids.
Okay.
And if person has obesity, free fatty acids usually are increased. So more person is obese, more fatty acids we have in our body. So free fatty acids are playing main role in insulin resistance. Mm. So that is where we have direct connection of obesity and type 2 diabetes. Mm. Mm-hmm. So free fatty acids are leading to insulin resistance and type 2 diabetes.
Okay.
So also this visceral fat is leading to very many different diseases. Mm-hmm. The WHO stated that around 64 types of different diseases are caused by visceral fat.
Wow.
Fat inside the body, guys. Yeah. If you got fat inside the body,
64.
That's a lot of different types of illnesses.
Whoa. So actually, I have a question. Based off of what you've said, can someone who doesn't look obese still have be obese, like, you know, have the fats around their organs? Can someone like me, who may not seem obviously obese, still be prone to getting or suffering from the 64 diseases?
We are going from the assessment.
Okay.
Mm. So it's not that we are looking at the person and we are saying this patient has overweight or obesity class 1.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. It is sometimes even difficult to say, to see that margin where you are in normal weight or you are overweight.
Oh.
So the easiest way and right way to do, just simply to check your body mass index.
Okay.
If your body mass index 24.9, you are still in normal weight. If your body mass index 25
and above,
and from 25 to 29.9, you are overweight.
Oh.
You may see person is looking absolutely nice. You don't even look that she has extra weight, but if you will check body mass index, you will find that she's already 27.
Right. Mm. And then 30 is where you're classified as obese.
Exactly.
Okay. Interesting.
If you have BMI 30 and above, it means that you started accumulating visceral fat in your body. It means that circulation of free fatty acids, circulation of those pathological hormones, those bioactive substances which are produced by visceral fat, already increased in your body. It means that you are more prone to inflammatory diseases, to atherosclerosis, diabetes, high blood pressure, and all those diseases.
I guess like the higher you go up that ranking, the more likely you could be predisposed to
these
more
diseases.
Illnesses.
Right. Yeah. And I know sometimes we can get a little bit scared of stepping on the scale because you don't want to know, if you don't see it, you assume it's not there. But it's wise to be able to calculate this as often as possible, just so you make sure you're within that safe zone. Mm-hmm. Okay, right. So my next question is, so are there maybe surgical and non-surgical options that are available that you could tell us more about?
Mm-hmm. Treatment of obesity depends on the stage of the obesity. depend on each individual case. To talk about treatment of obesity is very important to know causes of it. Generally, there are very many different causes, so that is why we need to use multidisciplinary approach.
Okay.
Usual weight loss methods, which people are using, like diet and exercises, are not effective enough. You are doing exercises, over the half a year you are able to lose weight, or even dieting, or meal plan, or tablets, or any food supplements, you are able to lose weight. That's what studies are showing. For 6 months, person can lose quite big amount of weight, even 30, even 40 kilos. You can lose with that tough diet. But what studies are showing, all the weight is coming back. And the person is gaining weight even more than he was before. So those tough diets, this is the way to obesity. The person is thinking he is losing weight, he is succeeding, but later on person is gaining weight, even gaining more than before. And that is what usual situation.
Okay.
With the dieting, you are losing 15 kilos. After stopping dieting, you are adding 20.
Even more.
Yeah. So what is part of a multidisciplinary approach?
Part of multidisciplinary approach to approach all different factors in obesity at the same time.
Okay.
And what factors are? We have social factors, psychological factors. When person has already morbid obesity, when we started accumulating visceral fat, and when person started developing diseases, already this hormonal mechanism, metabolic mechanism is switching on. So it's becoming even more complicated. So we have to address all those factors, looking at the present situation. So the most effective treatment of morbid obesity is bariatric surgery. It's accepted all over the world. I'm working in obesity treatment for more than 20 years. So we started from dieting, exercises, medical medications, different medications, food supplements. And while going on with the treatment, while seeing different cases, while meeting different resistant cases, we've seen that really only multidisciplinary approach should be used. So obesity surgery is very good tool in terms of treatment of morbid obesity. With obesity surgery is working in several ways. First of all, it is helping person to be satisfied with smaller amount of food. Secondary, it has, because it has restrictive effect, secondary, it has influence of those hormonal stimulants of appetite. Person is feeling less hungry. Another very good effect of bariatric surgery is that person is changing his eating habit and priority in food. So if before you used to like sweet stuff and fat stuff, after bariatric surgery, your priorities are changing. And you don't like so much now that sweet stuff, and you are very comfortable with that.
I think a lot of us, when we just hear bariatric surgery, automatically we just think, is that stapling of the stomach and that's it, or what part of the internal organs are we working on?
There are several types of there are quite a number of different types of bariatric surgery. The most often bariatric surgeries which we are performing at Nairobi Hospital, and the most oftenly used and popular bariatric surgeries are gastric bypass and gastric sleeve. So, if we are talking about gastric sleeve, for example, you're asking how this bariatric surgery is performed. Bariatric surgery became popular since the era of laparoscopic surgery. So, what gastric bypass is, it's we are reducing size of the stomach. When we are reducing size of the stomach, then with a smaller amount of food, person is becoming satisfied. Because if stomach is enlarged, more food you need to eat to feel satisfaction. And to feel satisfaction after eating is very important part in weight loss.
Okay. Oh.
If you are not satisfied after eating your lunch, whatever you do,
right,
you have to eat till you will get that satisfaction, that signal from the stomach that you are full. So during the gastric sleeve procedure, size of the stomach is reduced,
mm-hmm,
to the, I can say, to the normal size of the stomach. So it is, maybe it is a little bit smaller than it is normal size, but with the time, person is usually eating the same like all of us we are eating.
Okay.
But he is not overeating anymore.
Mm.
So it is very good step and very good support in terms of weight loss. So we can, like for example, we have obese person with 120 kilos, we can say.
Mm-hmm.
But his stomach is like stomach of person with 65 kilos.
Oh.
So it is good support. Person is not does not have those attacks of overeating anymore. He is eating very healthy food. Anatomy of digestive system is not changed. So I can say, but gastric sleeve, it is the most physiological procedure and done a lot. Many people
and done
different.
A lot in Kenya.
Done a lot in Kenya. For what, 15 years we do this procedure.
You've had the procedure, whatever the procedure may be, what is the recovery period length roughly? And the
recovery process. First of all, patient will be in the hospital 1 or 2 days.
Oh,
that's really short.
Even
yeah.
second, next day, person can be discharged. The thing is that procedure is already, those procedures are done in the world for over 40 years.
Mm.
So techniques is already very well developed. Mm. Then if it is gastric sleeve or gastric bypass, patient can be for 1 week off or 1 or 2 weeks off.
Oh.
Also depend on what type of job person is doing. If
right.
it is physical work, we can give Mosikov.
Mm.
If it is office work, after 1 week already person can go to work.
Wow. That's quick.
Yeah. That's amazing.
That's really I thought it would be like, you know, you need 3 months, don't
you know,
move a muscle,
lay
take
down.
It easy.
Yeah.
But it seems like it's actually
but
a
generally
quick
complete
process.
Complete recovery, if you can say, when person can go already for gym, like after 1 month.
Okay.
After 2 weeks already person is eating blended food.
Mm.
After another 3 week already person is chewing his food.
Mm.
By the end of first month you already eat your normal food.
At least we know where to find more information.
Exactly. And thank you so much again, Dr. Strukina, for coming and sharing your expertise on this topic. Like I've actually learned a lot from this. And remember, don't be scared to step on the scale and just make sure your BMI is, as she said, under 24.9. Is that the safe? Is that
it's normal weight.
Normal. And then, right. I mean,
About 25 is overweight.
Right.
Above 30, obesity.
Right.
So if you guys notice a change in the increase of your BMI, maybe it's time to go seek some medical help.
Exactly.
Or at least have a consultation.
Yeah.
And make sure you're living your best, healthiest life.
Exactly. Thank you guys for watching, and thank you again to Nairobi Hospital for letting you come on our show and share your expertise on this matter. We'll see you guys very, very soon. And as usual, make sure to leave a comment down below with your thoughts and subscribe to our channel as well. See you soon.
Eat healthy. Bye.
Bye.